Welcome to Hot Dog Vendor Radio and Street Food Vendor.tv. This is episode number 187 here on the Facebooks. And got Jason Brown of Love Food Truck Company with me. Thanks for being here. And he stayed up late last night watching the parade, the Eagles parade.
That was today.
Sent notes to the teachers at school, said his kids had the bird flu. All right. So we have, let's see, we've got Vendor of the Week this week is JB's on the run. Facebook.com/ JB's Watertown. JB's, that's JBS Watertown after your Facebook. Facebook.com, then that. James has been making headway working with local officials to make mobile vending legal in Watertown, Wisconsin. Been in the newspaper and stuff using info from Ben and Jason and the VU team to work with his town and getting things changed. Congratulations, JB's Watertown. Love it. All right, you ready for some questions? All right, this is from Ruben. Is there such thing as a good-tasting veggie dog? In my area, Phoenix and surrounding area, especially Scottsdale, which Scottsdale's the like a suburb of Phoenix, but high-dollar people. I've tried several. I can withstand it. And if you put enough crap on it, you can hide it. Nobody can hear you. I can hear you fine. What Jason was saying just a second ago was that that he's tried every vegetarian dog there is that he can find, and none of them taste good. That it was better tasting the cardboard box they come in. I've tried several. One I did a video live here with, and it was decent, but you have to pretty much cover it with stuff to hide, mask, and try to reproduce the texture, which is their hardest part of doing it, even though they use different types of soy protein and stuff, trying to make it resemble food, it doesn't work out so well. So I would just do a taste test with people that are vegetarians is your only way. Because if you have like someone like me or Jason taste test it, we're going to be biased towards meat. We want meat. It's you're not going to sacrifice your taste buds because you're thinking meat. You know what meat tastes like and you want meat. And they don't even come close to tasting the same. James said, yeah, earlier, but I can hear you just great. And it's showing your signal meter and everything's good on my end. Can y'all hear Jason? I hate that. I'm sorry, guys. Okay. Let me move through this real quick. We got some other ones. Can you talk about food handler's permit and food safety manager? What's required and what's not? Thanks for all you do. Food handler is just the basic permit that says, hey, I've taken a food safety class that meets the FDA standards and ANSI standards. ANSI standards were written by NSF. It's their little secret-y way to create their own codes that they have to approve. But the food manager basically shows that you have the ability to manage people under you who and their food safety. So if you have employees, it would be wise of you to have a food manager certificate, even if your state doesn't require it. All they're going to teach you, it's a 60 to 90 minute course. It's not that long. And it's multiple choice answers. And it'll say stuff like, what should you do if you drop a spoon on the ground? Or what's the purpose of the sanitization solution after you wash? Why wouldn't you just straight to rinse? So that's the kind of stuff they'll ask. It's pretty basic and pretty easy. Let's see. Well, that's for manager. I was saying for the basic course is about 60 to 90 minutes long. Oh, they do? Okay. Well, hey, Jason, I'm going to pull you out real quick and put you back in. I'm going to see if you're hearing. What he's saying is in the food manager is about a 3-day course. It's not like 3 8-hour days. Some of those courses are available through other people other than ServSafe. Like in Pennsylvania, I believe there's 4 different companies that are approved through ANSI and FDA. Right. I don't know. Hopefully they can hear you. Dave said it sounds like he's on the phone laying on the counter. How do you heat up a vegetarian chili on a big dog? I was telling Jason this question earlier, and Jason said you don't. You throw it away. Vegetarian chili on a big dog cart, I did it just like you do normal chili. You heat it up the same way. I put it in a water bath. So basically I have the spillage pan with water in it and then a pan inside of it holding the chili. Keeps the chili from scorching. You can use pan saver bags if you want. And then you can avoid cleaning the pan later, which is a great idea. We have samples of those on our website. Or you can go to pansaver.com and order them. The bottom line is the chili works the same. If you want a good vegetarian chili that is dynamite, and I would guarantee no one out there could say that it didn't taste like it had meat in it. You wouldn't know the difference if I blindfolded you. It's from Chili Man's. It's called Chili Man's Chili, and they've won 3 world records in chili cook-offs with a vegetarian chili that tastes just like it has beef in it. Last one, Jason. Aside from letting you know that I'm not a spammer, I do have a good question. Preempts it. It's going to be good. To the best of your knowledge and in your personal opinion, for upstate South Carolina, what are the must-have condiments? I'm a culinary major, so my own creativity will happen no matter what, but I would like to know what they're used to, basically. Okay, let me tell you, North Carolina, South Carolina, Tennessee, about the same. Sauerkraut, coleslaw, finally grated up coleslaw, Carolina slaw. It's still a mayonnaise-based slaw, but it's probably got a little bit of vinegar in it, so it's a vinegar mayonnaise base. It's got a little hint of sweet and twang. They finally grind it up for real slaw dogs. Those two are must. You might be in an area that likes jalapenos. You might not. Depends on the crowd where you're going to be. The other things, ketchup, mayonnaise, mustard. You have to have ketchup. I know there's people against ketchup, but you got to have it. I have to have it. People would just revolt if I didn't have ketchup. Somebody asked Jason, Lois Thomas, can you use canned cheese in Florida? Inspector said no. That's not real cheese, so you need to have your inspector tell you where they're getting that in the code. That is a processed food that you could have three nuclear wars and throw it in the septic tank and still fine. So anyway, that's it. I appreciate y'all being here. I hope it helps you with your questions. Yes, somebody just mentioned relish. You can have relish. Some people like relish in the Carolinas. I don't know if it's a must. I know there's vendors with it. I never did relish. It didn't matter. I say, except when I tried the Chicago dogs that didn't go over well. Well, I hope y'all had a good one. Thanks for being here. Talk to you later.